Hi there, my name's Ruben. I wrote this poor doctor's application using Genero Mobile, and in this video I'm going to give you a quick tour of the application and how to work it. So once you've started the application, the first thing you want to do is synchronize the data by clicking that refresh icon in the top right corner. That goes to our servers and does some web service calls to download some data. Now what the poor doctor's application does is it's a tool to simulate someone who's doing some repair on your pool, hence the pool doctor. And the process that's going to start it off is the customer's going to ring up your support center and say, hey, I want some work done. And so underneath the settings icon, we have this create random job icon, which simulates that process. So that's made a call to our web servers and created a job. And note the job number here, 116, 010116. Now if we go back up to our sync process and download all the jobs from our servers again, we'll see that we've got one new job loaded. And we tap on the anywhere on this icon to go to our next stream, which is a list of all our jobs. We can use these icons along the bottom to change the field, the data that's displayed, filter on the jobs, so we just want our new jobs, and change the order, so newest to oldest. And there we see job 116. That's our newest job that we're going to work with. So if we click on this job, it takes us through to a screen where we can see who the customer is and what parts we've allocated to the job, what photos we've taken, any notes and any timesheet. So let's go have a look at the customer details. So customer, click there. You can see we've got our customer code and name and address, phone number and email details. And from the screen we can have a look at the map to see where they're located. I'm using the simulator here, so I'm not able to call or SMS them, but I am able to mail them. So tap on the mail. And you see it's giving us the option to start an email to that customer. So if you're using a real device, if you tap call or SMS, that'll use the built-in API on the device to either call or SMS the customer using these customer details. Now before we can do any work on the job, we need to register the fact that we're starting it. So tap on the start icon. If we go back to our list of jobs, notice it's disappeared. I'll just change the filter back to all jobs. You can see 116. The icon has now changed to indicate that the job is in progress. This icon indicates new jobs, in progress, and complete jobs. So job number 116 is our job. Go into it, tap on the lines, and now we can start entering some parts. So we want to tap the plus icon to enter a new line, select a product from our list, and bang, we got one product entered against the job. Enter another one. Now when I'm entering these products, what I could do is read off a barcode as well. You'll be able to use that using the device. Again, on the simulator, I don't have that barcode functionality. Cancel out of there. Right, so I've got two products entered. I can take some photos. Again, if I wasn't using the simulator, we could see some photos. But basically, it's the same process. Click there, select a photo, and add it. We'll take a photo and add it. With notes, we can add some free text notes. And we can also record some time against the job. So that's using the GUI widgets. Clipboard to entering time to enable us to record some time against that job. So at this point I've entered two products, haven't taken any photos, entered one note and entered one timesheet entry for job number 116. Currently the job is in progress. If I come down and tap the complete button, then we can enter the name of the person who has signed off on the job and get them to enter their signature. Now if we look on the list of our jobs, we see the icon has now changed to indicate that the job is complete. If I go back to my main screen and sync the data again, that now goes up, and you notice the job has been uploaded and the job has been sent up to our servers. Other things on the screen, so we had that icon help, just puts up a little help document that we've got available on the web that you can read. It just tells you a little bit about some of the screens and what some of the buttons do. This video links to this video about just about us, Ruben at Blue Jay Software, who wrote this application. And underneath the settings icon, this is an icon you probably wouldn't have in your production system, but enables us to, as we saw earlier, create a random job. We can also delete all the job data, or we can force an error just to test the error handling mechanism. So that's a quick introduction to the Poor Doctors application. You'll see other videos showing how I've written that application as well. Hope that helps.